Hey, Vinyl Community, it's VK here on the Zep Pearl channel. And this is a video response to Dylan Harrison. Dylan Harrison is relatively new to the VC. I think he's doing like a 78 or something. He's just under 100 subs, but I think he's gone well over that. So to start off before, you know, I'll have a link below to Dylan's channel and the question he had for his contest. First of all, Dylan, hey man, I think you know you've known if you've recognized any of my comments, and I'm not sure if you're subbed to my channel, but I hope you are. Definitely, I'm really impressed with the knowledge that you have, and just the love of music. I mean, and don't take offense to this, but a kid at your age, in this day and age, to say that 1964 and 65 are his favorite years in music. That's pretty impressive, man, and I'm really proud of you. I'm sure your dad's probably really proud of you. You got a hell of a collection, man. You got stuff in there that trumps anything I have, for sure. I mean, some of the Yardbird stuff you got is great. So they want to give you props to that. And I'm sure people have told you that, but I wanted to let you know how I felt. And I also wanted to pay respect, and that's why I do these contest responses. It's not about the prizes and subs and all that stuff. Subs are overrated. In fact, I was just talking to some fellow VC people about that, and you know, the whole sub thing's kind of overrated, you know, because I have like what, 400 something, and you average maybe 100 views if I'm lucky, and half of those people probably just click the first 5 minutes, don't want to listen to me talk, and what I really think is pretty, you know, the fun part of it is the comments, man. I want people to kind of interact, talk, just say hey, whether you say hello or hey, you know, that was a great record, or you know, you go step by step, you know, through the whole video too. With that, I'm playing a little Yes, and my last video I did my Yes collection for Robert Z, and I don't know if you guys have seen that. I'll put a link below too for him. So you'll see a link down there for Dylan, you'll see one for Robert Z. Robert Z has a thread going on, show all your Yes collection. And what we're going to talk about now is Dylan. Dylan Harrison has a contest going on, and Dylan asked us to show albums from two of our favorite years. Now, that was a tough question, my friend. I really couldn't, I mean, I did pick out 2 years, but it was tough to say, you know, what would be a favorite. You know, I kind of just went off the top of my head and said, all right, well, here, I'll do these two. When looking at the two, I actually decided, okay, I'm going to stick to it. Okay, I'll do these 2 years. A lot of freaking great music came out in these years, even though, you know, it's not considered the golden era of rock music, which arguably some say is 1964 to 74, 75. That's probably a discussion for another time. Well, the years I chose was 1982 and 1985. When looking through 1982, man, I mean, I was going through there, and what a year of music that was. How many albums were released that year, and the titles that came out. So I thought, man, that's a lot of albums, you know, and I had a good portion of them. So I'm like, you know, I'm not going to pull all of them. But then I noticed something that I'm like, oh, well, of course, I got to do this. I got to show these, you know. All right, so you'll see what I'm going with here. 1982. The 1982 records I'm going to show, I have a little theme going on, too. We'll see if you notice that. 1982 was the first year we heard anything out of the remaining members of Led Zeppelin. And Jimmy Page released the soundtrack to the film Death Wish 2 in 1982. I believe this came out in, I want to say March. If not, maybe February. I think March of 82. Well, here's the inner sleeve. I know you wanted us to show everything here. So here's the inner sleeve. Just had the musicians and stuff on it. The backside was blank. I got like 2 copies of this. So this is my original copy. And then my brother LJ sent me up a backup, which was very cool of him. This is on Swan Song label, which was Led Zeppelin's recording label. Swansong had a busy year in 1982, and you'll see. So there's my first one. I only pulled out four albums for each. Like I said, man, it'd be an hour and a half video. So first selection is the soundtrack to the film Death Wish 2 by Jimmy Page. Okay. Number two came out in June of 1982. Robert Plant releases his first solo album, Pictures at 11. All right. It's a busy year for the members of Led Zeppelin that obviously weren't together again. All right, so there's the inner sleeve there. Had, you know, the musicians were on there. Here, check this out here. Two drummers here, Phil Collins and Cozy Powell. Cozy Powell, great, great drummer. Was in Whitesnake. Even was in ELP for an album. And obviously Phil Collins, we know, his solo work, and obviously Genesis. All right, and again, 1982, a busy year for the Swan Song label. And I'm sorry, I can't get enough of showing that one. Hey, man, it's the Zep Pearl channel. You know what we do here. All right, so Robert Plant, Pictures at 11, 1982. Then in November of 1982, Led Zeppelin released what is their final album. Some people aren't a fan of this album, but it was called Coda. The gatefold had pictures of the band. What this was is a collection of songs. I don't know if you want to say outtakes or songs that just weren't put on albums. There is one sound check in here, and kind of a song that was put together called Banjo's Mantra, which was an entire drum solo. There's the inner sleeve, and it had song information on the back when it was recorded and such. This is spanning songs from We're Gonna Groove, which was a song that they were doing, should have been on probably the first album, I believe, and they were doing live from the time they recorded it. In fact, if you have the DVD, they open up with that. Poor Tom from the third album, Sessions. There's a sound check of I Can't Quit You, Babe, which is just killer, actually. Walter's Walk came out of 72, so that could have been on Houses of the Holy. Ozone Baby, 78, that was during and through the outdoor sessions. Darlene, 76, could have been on Presence, Bonzo's Montrose, and Wearing and Tearing. So this whole second side, other than Bonzo's, three songs are here out of the in through the outdoor sessions. So, and again, and this is on Swan Song. But, so there's three albums from Led Zeppelin camp, I guess. Robert Plant, Jimmy Page, both, resurface with their solo albums, and Led Zeppelin put out Coda. But Swan Song was still very busy. There was another band, a very popular band, obviously had other bands on the label, but there was a really popular band that was on the label, and that was their friends Bad Company. And they released Rough Diamonds. You got the little die cut end there, get it? Rough Diamonds, kind of a cut there. This also had a die cut cover where when you slide it out, the picture comes out. There's the inner sleeve. And, this album didn't have really any big hits on it, but again, it's on the Swan Song label. So in 1982, Swan Song was pretty busy. Released four albums, maybe even more. I didn't really look, but they might have released some other, artists that were on there. But definitely, Bad Company puts out their last album with Paul Rodgers, and this was 1982. Bad Company wouldn't resurface here. There's the inner sleeve, or the, this is on the inside, actually printed on the inside of the label, the star, the diamond stars. There's the back. One of the popular songs, I guess Electric Land was kind of a, I guess you could say a hit. It was on their greatest hits, I guess. After Rough Diamonds, Bad Company split and wouldn't be heard of until about, I want to say 86, 87, because I saw the regroup with Brian Howe, the singer of Bad Company, on the, I think it's Fame and Fortune. They opened up for Triumph in 87 on the Sport of Kings tour, if my memory serves me right. So this was technically the last Bad Company album with Paul Rodgers until they regrouped maybe 1999, actually. And actually, I saw that tour, too. So there you go. From 1982, I got four albums. Rough Diamonds, Bad Company, Coda, Pictures at 11, and Death Wish 2 soundtrack, all released on the Swan Song label. All right, so we're going to juggle all those around, and you can pick your favorite. All right, next up, 1985, man, and I'm already clocking in at 10 minutes. I'm talking my ears off. 1985, well, I just decided to pull some live albums from 1985. Live, 85, get it? Live Aid happened in 85, so I don't know. But some here's some of my favorite live albums came out in 1985. Scorpions, Worldwide Live. You know, how can you not like the Scorpions, man? I don't care what kind of music you like, man. It's Scorps. That's on Mercury. Double live album. Recorded on the Love It for Sting tour. And which I got to see and just was killer, man. The Scorps in 84, 85 this time. Biggest band in the world, man, with Rocky Like a Hurricane. It's a huge hit for them. Next up, another favorite band. I mentioned them earlier. Triumph. Stages. Another great band. I believe this was recorded during the Never Surrender tour, if I'm not mistaken. This came out in 85 as well. This is on MCA. Don't know this. I don't know. Any of you guys out there know if it had a custom inner sleeve? Mine didn't come with that, even though I bought it back then. It's probably, you know, the record label ran out, so they just used the generic ones. A big, big monster live album also came out in 95, and no pun intended, Iron Maiden, Live After Death. What a huge tour this was. This was taking off the Power Slave tour. Look at that. And Eddie, the big mummy in there and everything, man. It was just... Nobody was doing a show like that, man. Maiden was the freaking shit. They had their own custom label on that. Capitol. Iron Maiden, man. Live After Death. Great stuff. A little wrinkle on here, damn it. Yeah, I was a kid, man. I was in high school. I graduated high school in 85. All right, and the last one, I did show this before, but this is, I showed this in my Yes collection, I think I was talking about earlier. This is Yes, 9012 Live, the solos, and I'll go a little more in detail on this. This is basically a live album of their solo stuff. So there's a solo here of Soon, one of the kind of a breakout solo during Gates of Delirium for John Anderson vocally. You had Amazing Grace on here, Whitefish, of course, Squire's solo, Tony Kaye and Psy, Trevor Rabin and Soily's Beard, and and Alan White. It was called Whitefish. Alan White and Trish Squire. So this was just a single album. Then they have two full songs, Changes and Hold On, are on here from 9012 Live, and that's on Echo. And I showed that before. Sorry for the repetitiveness, but it did come out in 85. So there you go. There's my selections for your contest, Dylan. Again, man, really love your channel. Love some of the things you're showing. You're showing some great stuff. Great collection. Great taste in music. I hope you dug some of those selections. And take care, man. Everybody, check out Dylan's channel. I have a link below. Jump in his contest. Show, you know, two or more albums from your favorite years. All right, everybody, take care. Dylan, congrats, and we'll talk to you, man.